Hello, hello, good evening. Yeah, we're doing a dolphin. Hi. I think so. Nice, like, pretty, like, blue palette. I'm excited. I have, like, three diamonds I need to paint, but I'm waiting for those to come in the mail. I ordered them, you know, last night, so probably by, like, tomorrow or Wednesday I'll have them. You guys, I have some awesome news. If you guys didn't see it on my Facebook group, hello, this morning, I got a code for 24-hour crafts. Woohoo! So now you guys have a code to use, which is like super exciting. I do use paint caps still, but when I'm using like a bunch of the same colors on like a bigger piece, sometimes it's a little bit easier for me to just do this so that I don't have to keep like putting on, screwing the tops back on, shaking them up and like opening them up because like, oh my gosh, my hands are so like dry and irritated because of like the winter time and it just like scrapes up my hands real bad and I freaking hate it. So yeah, sometimes, just not all the time. Oh, when I was younger, I wanted to be a marine biologist. Well, technically, I wanted to be a dolphin trainer, but, you know, marine biologists seem to be, you know, probably a better choice. But then I, you know, got older and realized I probably have to move somewhere warm. And I don't like hot weather, so I buy them. So yeah, so I reached out to 24-hour crafts and I was just kind of like, you know, I had already purchased something, you know, so, and then right after I purchased something, I reached out to them and I sent them a message and I was just kind of like, you know, hey, I really, really love your shop. You know, like I buy a good amount of my like wooden shapes from you guys. And, you know, I've been going back and forth about like asking you guys because one, like you're also a small business. And two, like I know that, you know, you pretty much constantly have a sale going on your Etsy. So like, I wasn't sure if it was like out of line for me to ask for like a discount code. But I was like, you know, I'm like a small influencer. I have, you know, 100,000 followers on TikTok and I live paint like, you know, 4 to 5 times a week. And I've been painting a lot of the pieces that I buy from you. And I know that I've been sending a lot of people your way. And I was like, you know, I'm not looking for anything in return. But I just thought it might be nice to be able to like provide a discount code, you know, to my followers in case, you know, they wanted to make a purchase from you. You know, I was like, and ultimately I just kind of decided, you know, the worst you can say is no. So he messaged me back this morning and was like, hey, Jenna, thanks so much for reaching out. And I basically was like, oh, here's like, you know, my website if you wanted to check out my art, you know, to like see that I'm legit, you know, blah, blah, blah. And he messaged me back and he was like, hey, Jenna, thanks so much for reaching out. You know, like I see whenever you do your reviews, you always post your art, like your finished product with our pieces, which I think is really awesome. I think your art is beautiful. And I love the fact that you're local. He was like, you know, it's funny that you reached out because last week we actually just started an affiliate program and, you know, it's not associated with our Etsy. It's only associated with our website, which makes sense because, you know, there's so many fees with Etsy and shit. But he was like, you know, I can get you an affiliate link that you can keep on your social medias and tell your people about. And, you know, I can give you a code for 10% off that you can give your followers. So now I have a code for 24 hour crafts in case you guys want to buy your own blanks there. I know some of you guys have been, but now there's an extra code, but you do have to go like via their website, which honestly like it's not much different than Etsy. In fact, their prices are cheaper than Etsy by about $1 a piece. That's nice. You know, I mean, they have to take into account their fees on Etsy, so that's probably why their stuff is just a little bit more expensive. But yeah, so if you go to their website, which I have them linked in my link tree, I think it's probably like the second or maybe the third option in my link tree. It says 24 hour crafts. I have their link, which it should just work by itself, just going to their website, like through my link. But also if you just use the code JGRONS10, you will get, 10% off your order. So yeah. And I think their stuff is already on sale on their website as well too. So it's just an extra 10% off of what's already there. So I'm not moving anywhere. I was just saying, in response to someone saying that, their daughter is a marine biologist and that she would, love, this. And I just kind of said, when I was younger, I wanted to be a marine biologist. I wanted to be a dolphin trainer. And then I grew up and realized that I'd have to move somewhere warm, probably somewhere tropical-ish. And I was just kind of no, thank you. So, you know, not going to be a marine biologist. I like it here in Pittsburgh. There really aren't any dolphin trainers / marine biologists in Pittsburgh. Maybe there's people at the zoo, but ultimately I just decided that, you know, that path in my life was probably just, you know, not where I wanted to be. But yeah, so I was super excited to tell you guys about it. I posted about it in my Facebook group earlier today, but I figured it would be easy to, you know, let you guys know on live, and you guys are going to probably hear some sort of that spiel every once in a while if someone asks me where I get my stuff. But hello. So yeah, I saw a comment quickly earlier ask if I made these blanks right or bought them. Was that what it said? Hold on. Do I make the boards or buy them? I buy them from 24 Hour Crafts, the place that I was just talking about. They're linked in my bio. So I'm just going to let that dry a little bit and we'll come back to it. Had a little bit of a paint booger that I did not catch and it just kind of dripped off my tool. Hey, what's up? This is one of these pieces. I don't remember where I got it. I've had it for a while. I dug through my craft or my wooden box, my box full of a bunch of different wooden pieces. And I grabbed a dolphin and I grabbed a big cat. So this is 12 inches. This isn't an 8-inch piece. So it's a little bigger, than the pieces that I have been doing, but that's okay. I figured it'd be pretty to paint this one up anyways. The last time I painted this shape, I just did a bunch of random scattered mandalas all over the place. And I left most of it blank or black. So I wanted to really paint this one up, completely fill it up and see what it looks like. I think it's going to look really freaking pretty whenever it's done. It does. Sometimes. Hey, I'm good. How are you? But yeah, so I was cleaning earlier, so that's why I got on at 6:30. I mean, this is my normal time, so, you know. Thank you. What was that? Oh, the cat is on the dryer. I'm just going to ignore him because he's just going to be trying to get in the closet anyways his whole life. So, whatever. We don't want him to disturb us. Yeah, so I figure we're going to do something cool with this. I don't know exactly how it's going to turn out. I'm sure it'll turn out just fine, but since I've never done this shape before like this, I just don't know how it's going to turn out. I'm sure it'll be pretty though. So how's everybody's Monday going? Is it a Monday for you, or is it like, you know, just an average, pretty decent, no complaints kind of Monday? Mine's pretty average. No real complaints. I slept in today by accident. I wanted to get up and go to the gym, but I didn't wake up until almost 11. And at that point, like, it's too late for me to go to the gym. I had some things to do today. So, but besides that, it was a pretty decent Monday. I did my normal, like, you know, vacuuming, cleaning the house, you know, all that kind of stuff. Did some laundry. Then I went actually, like, cleaning. But the colors are pretty. I can't wait to do some top dots on these. 60 degrees and hey, yeah. It's pretty warm here. I think it's, like, low 40s maybe it was a little colder than that, but I mean the weather was fine. Nothing to complain about. No snow, no ice, no rain, nothing like that. So pretty decent here. It's a Monday for sure. Oh no. Well, hopefully Tuesday is better for ya. Might have to fix that area a little bit. I'm not liking how that's all meeting together. I think I started messing it up right about here. No big deal. We can fix it. We can fix it quite easily. It's just gonna look a little crappy for a second while it dries. What kind of song is on right now? Hello. Mm-hmm. I know. You got good weather and you're like, all right, this isn't normal. What's on its way? Thank you. Yeah, Texas gets really crazy weather. It's like it's nice and hot, and then it frickin' gets really cold and, you know, icy and terrible. Well, you don't want to move to Pennsylvania, or at least Pittsburgh, because our weather, we always say, is just bipolar as hell. We never trust the weathermen. You know, they say we're going to have, you know, X, Y, Z kind of weather, and then it's like the complete freaking opposite. Like, we haven't had, like, really freaking bad weather yet this year, which is kind of scary, because I feel like we're kind of due for it. But, you know, Scott's pretty, like, I'm okay if we don't get any, like, bad snow or anything this year. And I'm like, I want, like, one or two bad snows. And, like, I want it because, you know, I don't have to worry about it. I'm not going anywhere, so it's not gonna really impact me one way or another. But I know most people don't want any kind of crappy weather. But I don't know, there's just something, like, nice about sitting inside, not being able to go anywhere, just being cozy, you know. I'll just paint all day long. You don't gotta tell me, you know, to paint. I'll gladly sit here and paint. All right, while this area dries, we'll do some top dots. I want to bring in, like, some, like, color shifters, I think. That'll be nice. I'm going to use this Folk Art color shift, the blue flash. So it's got, like, a blue-purple flash. I think that's going to be quite pretty on here. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, I wouldn't mind it because I won't have to go anywhere, but those people who do have to go anywhere, they're definitely not gonna enjoy it. Like, whenever I was, like, going places for work, you know, like not staying in my house all day and working. The worst thing was getting up in the morning and having to freaking clean my car off and then make my way into work and just deal with all the bad weather and the traffic and everything else. And it was only like a 10-minute drive, but it was not a fun 10-minute drive. My car didn't even get warm enough, you know, by the time I got to work. So I was just freezing the whole time driving to work. It was just not fun. Uh-oh. Everything all right? Or did you not get results yet? Oh, well, hopefully, you know, everything is as okay as it can be and nothing too serious, and that you get some, like, answers that you need. Fingers crossed. I know some people don't like it when people say, like, prayers, but, you know, I'll be thinking about you, and hopefully everything is okay. But yeah, the waiting part is the worst. I totally agree with that. Especially if you're like me, like I get in my head and like I just think the worst until, like, you know, I know for a fact that I'm okay. And thankfully, anytime I have had to worry about anything, I've been fine. But like, I'm just the worst with that kind of stuff. I always just overthink everything. And it doesn't help that, like, I have a little bit of, like, a medical background. I mean, like, I went to school for things, and, like, my parents are both in the medical field. So, like, I feel like I know a little bit more about certain things than, like, you know, your average person. So, like, that does not help me. Sometimes you would think that it does, you know, because you can, like, calm yourself down and, like, be like, no, like, you're, you know, you feel this way because of X, Y, and Z. And, but, like, in actuality, it's like, well, Jenna, you could have A, B, and C, and that's why you're feeling this way. And then I freak myself out. yes. That is scary. I can't relate. I'm sorry. Thankfully, like, I don't really have that in my family, but I mean, I know that that doesn't really mean, like, nothing would happen, but I have a lot of friends and people that I know that, you know, they go through that kind of stuff, and it is really scary, but, you know, thankfully, at least, you know, with most of, like, the medical stuff these days, like, just doing, like, your regular screenings and, you know, things like that can at least help to catch things early enough. For the most part, this is all me, right? I know. I like can't believe I really haven't done a dolphin recently, like, at all. It's really big too. This is 12 inches. I measured it because I'm like, this definitely isn't like an 8-inch piece. This is definitely bigger than that, and it's like 12 inches. So it's gonna be nice, pretty large dolphin piece. I'm excited to see it. Congratulations? I don't know, what's the word to say for people with that kind of stuff? Is congratulations, or what's the, like, the good memento, like, oh my god, I can't talk. This day and age, like, I swear, like, some things you say in, like, good meaning, and then it's not taken the right way. Like, what's the good thing to say? Is congratulations a good thing? I'm happy for you? I don't know. But yes, I hope everything goes well. And hopefully you get, you know, answers soon so that you don't have to, you know, keep worrying and guessing. Maybe. But yeah, I went to the like girly doctor like earlier or like middle of last year-ish. Well, I couldn't really get in till October. But like I had like a normal checkup and there was like something abnormal and like they didn't like get a hold of me. Like, you know, my doctor was like, oh, we'll call you. And like hadn't heard anything for months. Like I think I had an appointment in like April. And then October, I got like an email saying like, hey, we've been trying to reach you. And I'm like, no, the fuck you haven't. Like I logged on, like nothing, like no phone calls, nothing. So I call and I'm like, hi, like, I, you know, I think I have to like do a, some type of like retest. Like, I don't know, but like, you know, I haven't heard anything, but according to like the phone message I got, like you guys have been trying to reach me and like, you know, you definitely haven't. Like, I feel like I would have noticed. I was like, so anyways, like, I'd like to make an appointment. And they were like, okay, like we can't get you in for like another like month. And I'm like, seriously, like, if it's something that, like, you feel the need to, like, rescreen for, like, why the frick do I have to wait that long? And so, like, for a month, I was, like, freaking out, thinking I had some type of, like, probably, I think it might have been, like, cervical cancer, I think was what I was scared of, because, like, you know. But when they, like, did, like, the retest thing, the doctor, I mean, I know that you're not really supposed to say it, but like during the visit she was like, I don't think it's anything bad, like we'll send this off, but like I don't think it's anything bad, don't worry about it. And so like that calmed my mind, and of course like I got the results back and everything was fine. And it's just some part of me that's always probably going to be abnormal, and you know, every couple years I'm going to have to just like, you know, get an extra test done just to, you know, make sure. But it was scary. It definitely was scary. That's what I mean. Like, I was like, what? Like, if it's something that, like, they feel the need to, like bring you back in to do more testing, like, I feel like you definitely, like, shouldn't have to wait very long for an appointment. So, yeah, for a month, I was freaking. But I wound up being okay. But, like, my friend, she had cervical cancer. And so, like, I, you know, was thinking about her. And I'm like, oh, my God. Like, and she had it, like, I'm 28. And I think she had it at, like, 27. So I'm like, you know, it's definitely, like, not out of the question for me. Like, hopefully not. But, like, obviously, like, someone close to me had it. So it's possible. And so I was just freaking out. Hate waiting for paint to dry. This freaking black right here, I'm just waiting. So I'm just doodling, doing a couple like top dots, using some color shifters just to make it extra pretty. Oh my gosh, yeah, like that. That's something that's like on my mind too. I'm like, I'm gonna probably have to start getting checked for those eventually, and I don't want to do that. And it's just, I don't want to get any older. I want to like stay young and not have anything happen with my body. Why do we have to get old, you know? Why do we have to have things like this in our lives? Why can't we just live happily and not have to worry about this kind of shit? Hi, Tub Tub. What you been? Are you trying to cuddle? Trying to cuddle already? I just sat down, man. You just sat down, Fuzz Fuzz. Right, exactly. Like, I don't want to be too young. I don't want to be too old, you know? Old enough to, like, make my own decisions and, you know, that kind of stuff. But not too old where, like, everything hurts and my body is starting to fail me. Oh, that's so scary. That's what happens to my mom quite often, and she's always fine. So I just like pretty much assume that whenever I have to start getting that kind of stuff, like I'm just gonna have that scare as well. 140. Ugh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, what happened? I want my calculator back. Thank you. 42, 6. All right, I think I know. I was just doing a little bit of math. A little bit of math, okay. 1, 1, 2, 3. No. All right, my math worked for a second and now it's not working. So give me a second to figure it out. Oh, I need to wipe this off because I'm going to keep marking little bits of paint on here. Okay, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. There we go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right, let's just go for it. Just little dots in case I have to wipe them off. Yeah, all right, we got it, we got it. Well, hopefully with just like regular screening, everything just stays okay. So basically, if you guys didn't really see what I was doing, there's no real like mathematical equation to determine how many dots you can easily or evenly fit around the circle. Obviously, like it's all going to be different because it just kind of depends on like this first row right here. And I don't go into that row like trying to fit any certain number. I just kind of make sure that the dots fit, you know what I mean? So basically what I did was I picked just a random spot in between one of, you know, two of these dots. Just one random spot as like a marker so that I didn't lose my spot when I was counting. And then I counted all of the spaces, like all of the in-between spaces in between the dots. And then after I got that number, I went to my calculator and I divided a bunch of numbers. So I had, I think, 42. And so I'm like, all right, how many, like, what numbers go into 42? And so I divided 42 by 3, and that got me 14, like, evenly, like, no decimal point. So I knew that I could do every, like, 3 spots, I could put a dot. And so that gets me, like, something even. It doesn't always work out that well. Sometimes it's an uneven number, and it's really hard to, you know, find something that fits nicely, and sometimes you just kind of have to wing it and hope that it looks good. But in this case, I was able to do, like, a tiny bit of math with the help of a calculator to get me an even number. So that was exciting. So it's not really math, though, you know, you just have to count and then you use your calculator. For me personally, I'm not a math person. That wasn't too bad. It wasn't too bad. I think the hardest part is just making sure you counted the spaces correctly. I always, like, you know, I always second guess myself, but it worked out. So I'm not gonna fight it. There definitely could be worse math. There was no real equation. Sometimes I feel like if there was an equation, though, it might make it a little bit easier, because there's a tiny bit of guesswork that goes into it and kind of like crossing your fingers. But I guess I started off with a nice number of dots going around the circle, so it was pretty easy. Sometimes, like, you need it, though, right? If you want to try and have it as symmetrical as possible. And, like, for me, since I freehand most of this, I need to, like, start off on a good note. Otherwise, it's just not going to look good. Or as good. It's not going to look as good. So, I do, like, the most basic math and counting that I can for this. So, no, I've had these tools. I just lost them. I got them only because they were, like, rainbow. There's nothing really special about them. They're actually, like, the most expensive tools that I have. These were over $20 just for 4. But I liked them because they were, like, rainbow, and I thought that they were fancy. But no, not a new dotting tool. I refuse to curve or bend these ones, because if I accidentally break it, like, there's nothing I can do. I just wasted, like, 20-some dollars because I broke it. So I refuse to bend these ones just because I don't want to break them. I don't really trust myself enough, because I have broken quite a few tools trying to bend them up, which is why I say be careful if you do try to do it, because they break. But yeah, I just got them because they were fancy and pretty, and literally no other reason. Like, they aren't any better or worse than regular dotting tools. Thank you. I am on my regular Monday, Tuesday night live, so we'll be on until 8 o'clock. Right around 8 o'clock, and then I'll get off for the night. So I don't know if you guys saw anything online, but, apparently, and I don't know if Costco has them, I know Sam's Club has them, but they're these, like, chicken nugget type things that apparently are supposed to be, like, the Chick-fil-A chicken nugget, like, the little nugget things. And I really don't like Chick-fil-A, I don't really see the hype, but, like, Scott, he loves Chick-fil-A, so if we ever go, I always just get, like, the little nuggets. They're fine, whatever. So he saw them, like, online. I guess people were talking about them, how they're, like, a perfect, like, dupe for the ones you get at Chick-fil-A. And so when we were at Sam's Club the other day, we found them, and he was like, oh my gosh, let's get them. And I was like, okay, cool, like, whatever, sure. So we were like, let's have, like, chicken salads, like, last night. And so I popped some in the air fryer, you know, I cut up some lettuce, got everything ready, you know, And I made the salads, and we sit down to eat, and I take a bite first, and I'm like, do these taste weird to you? Hey! Like, I feel like they taste like pickles. I was like, I taste pickles. And he, like, takes a bite. He goes, oh, no, I don't like these. And I'm like, I don't understand. Like, I thought that they were supposed to be, like, the Chick-fil-A things. Like, I saw, like, a pickle on, like, the packaging, but I just kind of figured, you know, like, Chick-fil-A puts pickles on their sandwiches, which I think is gross. Like, I love pickles, don't get me wrong, but, like, I don't like pickled flavored things, and I like pickles on, like, hamburgers, but, like, that's it, you know? And so he gets up and he looks, and, like, they're literally dill flavored, like, chicken nugget things. And we were like, what the hell? And so, of course, we were like, yeah, no, we're not eating these. So we had to get some, like, different, like, chicken, like, we have, like, chicken tenders, so I had to, like, make those, and I was just like, oh. So if you guys, like, were thinking about buying them, unless you like pickled flavored things, and not just pickles, because I like pickles, if you don't like pickled flavored things, I don't recommend. Don't waste your money, because it was definitely a surprise to my taste buds when I ate it. I was like, uh-uh, don't like it. Hey. Me too. Growing up, dolphins were my favorite animals. And honestly, I feel like they still kind of are. Like, dolphins and penguins are my favorite animals. So I was digging through my box of wood today, trying to find a new piece to paint. Because, I mean, yeah, I've been doing a lot of, like, cats and dogs and stuff. But, and we did, like, turtles and frogs recently. But I figure be nice to do a dolphin, because right now I don't have any orders to make right now. So I mean, I do, but I'm waiting on the wood to be delivered. So it's kind of like a free paint slash like new inventory moment. So I figure this one would be pretty. It's big. It's 12 inches. So the other stuff is usually about 8. This guy is 12. So it's going to be nice when it's all done, but I'm excited to see, I'm excited to see what it looks like, because the shape is interesting too. So I kind of want to see like how this design kind of translates into like a dolphin shape. What's going on, Ash? I just want to put top dots around this, like, ring. They're just, it's not dry yet, and I have to, like, you know, be patient. Like, finish up, like, some painting stuff. I feel that. I have been, like, meh this month so far. It's been, like, really slow, and, like, I haven't had any, like, really good interactions on, like, TikTok or Instagram or anything, and so I just kind of, like, feel like a lot of my stuff has kind of been, like, a flop. I'm just really struggling to get, like, views and get my stuff out there. So it's been, like, a really slow month so far, and it's just, like, kind of depressing. And, like, February last year was really slow for me. February and March were really slow for me. And so I'm just kind of, like, not looking forward to these 2 months, and I'm trying to kick ass. But, you know, there's only so much I can do. If no one sees my stuff, then, you know, no one sees my stuff. But I gotta keep creating. It's just hard. No, I haven't. I have not. What you working on? My neighbor's being hella loud right now. It's so not fun. It's just like, Like, I had some videos that I posted earlier, and I don't know what they're at now, but, like, I was at 8 views, 13 views, like, after, like, hours after I posted them. And I'm like, what is going on? I also, like, lost more followers, so, like, I'm not at 100.1 anymore. I went back down to 100. And I'm just like, what's happening? Can we stop? Can I just please grow a little more? Ooh, nice. I painted this, like, this holder. It has, like, little, like, knobs on it. And, like, all it needs is another layer of resin. Like, it's done. It's been done. I just, like, haven't done the resin yet. Because I just, like, haven't felt like it. But it's really pretty. It has these, like, crystal, like, knobs that you can screw on. I painted it, like, sometime last year. And I've just, like, never finished it. But it's, like, something that you can, like, hang leashes on. Or, like, keys or something like that. I'm just, like, I need to like, finish it. Because it's so pretty. It's just, like, I'll show you. It doesn't have, like, the knobs or anything on it. Because I put them somewhere and I have to find them. But I found it at, I can't remember. It might have been Walmart. But there are three, like, the knobs go in here. They screw in. And you just hang it, like, it has these little hooky things, you just hang it. So this whole thing, like, needs another layer of resin, because there's just, like, a couple areas that are just not, you know, fully covered. And I just, like, haven't, like, felt like putting resin on it yet and putting it together. But, like, honestly, like, I really should, because this is probably gonna be really pretty. I'll get there eventually, though. I mean, how long did it take me to, like, actually do, like, the large sea turtle? Like, it was, like, 90% done, 95% done, and I didn't finish it for a couple months. I'm the worst at that. Like, I just, some stuff, a lot of stuff I'll finish right away, but then there's other stuff that, like, maybe there's, like, a small, like, bump in the road, and I'm just like, yeah, I don't feel like doing this right now. Like, I have that launch of, like, my, like, collection, the Elements collection that I was working on, that I wanted to have, like, up and launched by, like, the end of January. And right as I was about to, like, you know, I was doing the final clear coat on the paintings, I messed up two of them with the clear coat I was using. It just made, like, a bunch of, like, the paint, like, wrinkle, and there's, like, nothing I can do about it. And so I'm like, well, I guess I'm not releasing them right now, because, you know, two out of the 6, 7, 8 pieces that I have, like, are not, they're kind of ruined right now. I have to make new ones, and I just, like, haven't. But last night I made some new, like, alcohol ink canvases so that I can, like, paint the new ones. So maybe I'll do some of that tonight. But it just, sometimes it takes me a while. I, like, shut down. If something doesn't work out the way I want it to, I, like, go into my head, and I just, I don't know. I just stuck my hand in paint. You know, I don't know, but it's just not fun. Sometimes I do. But honestly, it's really hard not to, you can't really go wrong with, like, blues, I think. I think that just, you can do so much with blue color palettes, probably why I'm drawn to them. But yeah, and, like, I know some of you guys said, like, sell them for, like, cheaper, but, like, since this is, like, my first ever collection, like, I want them to be, like, perfect, you know? So, like, this is the worst part of this one. You can see that it started to wrinkle, but if you, like, really look at it, you can see that, like, in some of the other areas too, throughout the entire piece, the paint wrinkled up, and there's nothing I can do to fix it. I can't scrape it off. Like, painting over it's just gonna, like, make it look lumpy. So, like, that piece got, like, ruined, which sucks, because this one was one of my favorites. And then same with this one. This one also did the same thing. Like, all of this area, like, pretty much on all of them, and you can see that I tried to scrape it off, and I just made it worse, and, it started removing, like, the alcohol ink as well, so I'm, like, I can't fix that either, and as you, like, look more, like, in, you can see that it's also doing that, so, I think it wrinkled because I was using patio paint, which typically I don't have an issue with, but I used a spray sealant instead of like a, like the Duraclear or like a, you know, paint on like glossy seal coat. I used a spray and I think that it reacted somehow, because like you're not supposed to seal patio paint. But, I mean, I used it on all my ornaments and sealed it, and it was fine. And so it was, like, my go-to white for a really long time. But then I had that little oopsie moment. So, yeah. Now I have to make new ones. Thankfully, I caught it when it happened, and I, like, didn't spray everything at once. I was going to. Like, I was all set up to spray everything, and I looked down, and I saw that happening, and so I stopped. And then I used Duraclear for everything else, and it was totally fine. So, two of them, when I sealed it with a spray coat, it started making the paint, the white paint wrinkle. And, like, if you look close enough, like, a lot of areas are doing that, and there's nothing I can do to fix it. So, like, the blue, the small blue one and the small purple one did it. Also, I noticed that there's a chip on this one that I didn't notice for a while. I don't know. So, like, along with, like, you know, this happening and, you know, it's kind of throughout this, like, I just don't feel comfortable selling it as part of the collection because, like, it's my first collection. I want it to be perfect. And so now I have to make new ones, and, I just haven't been in the mood to paint them. You know, I'm just in a funk. Like, that literally set off my funk, and I just, like, haven't really been able to get out of it yet. But last night I did two new, like, alcohol ink canvases in preparation to, you know, repaint those two, designs. So I'm, like, closer than I was, you know, but I still haven't remade them. So, like, my launch is kind of on a pause at the moment until I can get those ones done. Because I just, like, haven't felt like working on them. And it's just sad. But it's fine. Eventually we'll get there. Maybe by the end of this month. Hopefully. Hey, Tara. What's going on? This tail is, like, making me mad because it's, this piece is longer than the other pieces. So anytime I, like, turn it, it, like, catches on, like, anything that I'm trying to move. It's just annoying. Oh, well. And having one of those, like, lazy Susans, it's not going to help me in this instance. Not that it, you know, I think it would help me anyways because you guys know my feelings about those, but the tail is just getting in the way. I just want to cut the tail off for right now while I work on it. I do. I think it was the white paint. I think it was the type of white paint that I used because you're not supposed to seal it technically because it's a patio paint. It seals on its own. But, like, I wasn't having an issue with it any other times that I used it. But I also haven't used, like, a glossy spray sealant in a while. I've been pretty much using Duraclear, but since I had that little issue with the Duraclear cracking recently, I kind of, like, have been not using the Duraclear as much because I'm scared to, like, you know, that it's gonna happen to one of my other pieces, even though I'm pretty sure I just used too heavy of a coat. I don't know. So at this point, I'm still kind of, like, juggling with, like, sealants and what works and what doesn't. And I just, you know, I guess it wasn't the right kind. And I used Duraclear for the other ones, and it was fine. So, I don't know. I mean, I still, it happens, you know. We learn all the time. There isn't, like, one good sealant that I feel like works 100% every single time. I got a little bit. I didn't hear, like, too much. Like no one could like leave a review, you know, because it wasn't the transaction wasn't done on my Etsy and it wasn't done, you know, like on my website or anything. I mean, the lady who organized it all, she texted me a few times and said that like the parents, like they're loving the ornaments whenever they came to pick it up. I had one person like Venmo me extra money because she didn't think that she paid me enough and she thought that I deserved to be paid more, which is really nice of her. She didn't have to do that. But yeah, like I really haven't, I haven't heard like too much. I got a couple little bits of feedback like during, you know, the holiday season, but I haven't heard anything since like Christmas time, which is fine. But like maybe, you know, hopefully next year they, you know, order some more ornaments for me. I don't know. Oh, really? Yeah, I wasn't expecting to get it today. And then I heard my mailman. I think I have a new mailman because one, my mail is coming has been coming like a little bit earlier than what I'm used to. And two, like anytime I have a package, he knocks on my door, which like a post office, they don't usually do that. So I just think I have a nice new mailman. And so when he knocked on my door today, I was like, what kind of package did I get? And when I opened my door, I saw that it was my package from Down Glitter Hauler. And I'm like, ooh, happy Monday to me. I mean, it's nice because she lives in Maryland and I'm in Pennsylvania. So, like, I always get my orders from her, like, pretty darn quickly, like, usually within a day or two. So, when I got the notification the other day, I knew that it was coming, but I totally forgot about it until I got the knock on my door. Thank you. They were really pretty, but they were a pain in my bum. They were a pain in my butt to make. I liked making them, but I didn't like making 115 of them. definitely like learned a freaking lesson of what not to do, especially during the holiday season. It was fun, but like I felt like it kind of impacted me a little bit like negatively because I wasn't able to like paint different things for you guys as often as I like really wanted to. Like anytime I was live, I was basically doing the same thing. And like, I know there were a lot of you guys that like were super supportive and, you know, didn't really care what I was painting. You guys just wanted to watch me live, but like I was bored of the design. And so I can only imagine how like some other people were feeling, whether it be the ones who wanted to watch me or not, or just some people that are like, oh my God, she's painting the same thing again. Like, I don't feel like watching this. I just wish that I could have done more designs and more ornaments with you guys last year than I did because I was, you know, literally stuck painting all those ornaments until like Christmas. So next year it's not going to be like that. Yes, 10% off a 24-hour craft. Those of you guys who didn't hear me talk about it earlier, I get most of my wood pieces from 24-hour crafts. I don't know if I got it, this one from them because it's been like a year and a half at least since I bought this. I just like haven't painted it. But 24-hour crafts is where I get most of my wooden blanks that I paint on. I love them. They ship very, very quickly, like literally within 24 hours. But I did reach out to them last night and ask them if there was a way that I could get a discount code for you guys. And they responded back this morning saying yes, they have an affiliate program. And so it doesn't work through their Etsy, but they do have a website. And honestly, their website is cheaper than Etsy anyways because they don't have to account for like the fees that Etsy has. So their stuff is about $1 cheaper or so on their website than it is on Etsy. They still have the sales, so you don't have to worry about missing the sales that Etsy might have. They still run the sale on their website. And on top of that, you get an extra 10% off. I have a code linked in my link tree. I think it's like the third one down. Either way, it says 24-hour crafts. You should just be able to click the link and whatever you purchase through there should automatically be a 10%. But if it doesn't, just use the code JGRONS10, all caps, JGRONS10 to get 10% off of your order. So yeah, I finally got a code. I know you guys were like asking, and we've kind of been going back and forth about whether or not I should ask them for one or not, but I finally did ask them and they said yes. So yay. Hooray, hooray. Also trying to get a code for Lotus Laser Works, which is the other place that I like to buy my wooden shapes from. I have not heard back from them, but, you know, I might not ever hear back from them. But I did reach out to them, too, just in case. But, yeah. That was exciting news from this morning. I wonder how many people they have as their affiliate since they just launched it last week. I don't know. Maybe I'm there first. Who knows? But it is fun. So now I have codes for glitter and I have codes for wood. I just need deco art to like get on the train and talk to me. Someone get a hold of deco art and tell them to stop ignoring me. Like we need like another color in here, like maybe like a dark blue. I feel like we need a dark blue. Ooh, no, we need this blue. Flying paint. We need this blue because it is pretty. Should we do metallic blue or should we do silk blue that has kind of like that goldish shift? We have like a metallic, like navy blue, or it's kind of metallic-y. It's more of like a mica, like glittery kind of one. I don't know. Or both. I don't know. Maybe we'll use some metallic blue. Right? Yeah, I've been applying to deco art and like, their stuff is closed now. So like, I can't apply anymore, but I've applied a couple times and haven't heard shit. So, all right, silk, got it. Here we go. Silk it is. Getting some top dots done just so that I don't have to reach over my design as much as it continues to kind of build outwards. Thank you. Yeah, they are kind of a big deal. They have like a maker program, but yeah, I just they've since closed it and you know, they're just ignoring me. It's fine. Maybe one of these days. But whenever I applied for, like, there's not a spot for TikTok. There's only a spot for, like, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram. And, like, TikTok is my largest, like, most successful, you know, account. So, I don't know. Maybe that's why. But I don't know. Kind of surprised that they haven't like jumped on like the TikTok train, because you know there are so many of us on here. Oh shit, really? It should be Jgrons 10, capital Jgrons 10. I'll have to double check. Maybe I just put Jgrons. It's Jgrons 10. It should be automatically associated with the link in the bio. But if for some reason it doesn't work at checkout, you can always put the Jgrons 10 code in and it should work. I agree. Hopefully they do. It would be nice. You guys, I got a new tool today. I have to, like, link it, but, like, you guys can always look it up on Amazon, although again, I don't know the name and I threw out the packaging, so I'll have to look. But it helped me make a larger circle on this piece because, you know, the Helix tool that I have, it's only so large. And so I wanted to get something else that kind of worked, and like rulers work, but like they don't have like, not like most of them don't have like a bunch of holes, you know, and I hate protractors because they just don't work for me. So actually Anthony, he's not on here, but Anthony, he sent me a link on Instagram to something that he found on Amazon that he thought would be helpful. And when I looked at it, I was like, oh yeah, that looks like major helpful. So once I get this circle of dots done, I will show you guys what I got and how to use it, because it's definitely, if you guys like these designs and you guys have been doing these designs and want to do them like bigger scale, maybe on like a canvas or even just like a larger shaped animal, it's definitely going to be probably a tool that you're going to want to buy. And it's only like $6 or $7. So like, it's not expensive, you know, it's not really that expensive, you know, compared to, you know, some other tools. Like I saw someone buy some tool and they said they spent like $200 or $300 on it. And I just like LOL'd, because I'm like, yeah, you can definitely like, you don't need to spend that money on something like that. Like you can get a cheaper one and make it work. Like what? Like I'm all for like luxury items, don't get me wrong, but like I also like saving money. And if I can get something that works the same way, you know, for less than the main price, like I'm gonna freaking do it. But anyways, that's not the tool I'm gonna show you, but that was just kind of reminded me of it. But yeah, so just a couple more dots, or maybe like more than a couple, but just trying to get this ring of blue done, and I will show you my newest tool. Thank you. Yeah, this is a color shift. It's the Folk Art Flash, or color shift, I guess. It's called what? Blue Flash? Yeah, Blue Flash. So it has like a purple blue color shift to it. It kind of looks grayish on camera, but it's like a kind of like a stormy blue kind of color. So I guess kind of like a gray blue color. But it has like a purple kind of like shifty mica type of thing in it. And so it shifts from like a blue color to purple. And I just think it's really pretty. I love to use this one in like my blue color schemes. I just think it's just extra pretty. This is 12 inches. This is a big guy. I mean, he's like 12 inches long, basically from like the top of the fin to the bottom of the tail, it's 12 inches. So, I can't exactly remember the size, but it's definitely at least 12 inches. And I have to like dig back in when I feel like maybe I bought it on Etsy, but at the same time, I don't know if I did. So I kind of have to go through my order history, like back like a year and a half, to see if I can't find like where I bought it from. I don't know if it was from 24 Hour Crafts or not. I know the original transaction, or the transaction, like the reason I bought this was because someone wanted it and it was from Etsy. So maybe I just have to dig through my conversations and see if I can't find like the size that she wanted, because I ordered it for what she wanted and then she mentioned that she might want a second one. And so I just kind of figured I'd grab a second one just in case, and then she never wanted a second one. So now I was kind of stuck with this. But yeah, so it's, I think it's at least 12 inches. Okay, so new tool. It's a Helix tool, but I don't remember like what it's called. I'll have to find it after this live, because I threw out the packaging today. But so this was my normal Helix tool, right? So it's great, you know, you find the center and, you know, you stick your like pen or whatever around, right? So for this one, I kind of want to use a different piece of paper, because, well, we'll use this one because this part's kind of fucked up. All right. So, you're supposed to like stick something in the center, I just use my nail because, you know, I got long nails. It's fine. So I need more lead in my pencil, so that's why I can't use a pencil right now. So we'll use a pen. So it has the dots, or like the holes, just like that circular tool. But this just gets you like a larger circle. So let's say this is the center. I don't know. You pick, I gotta move this over. But you pick a dot and it just makes your circle. Just kind of like that circle helix tool that I was using. But this one just makes it a larger one. So that kind of allows me to make a larger scale circle. So yeah, I really like this. So this paired with this is like the perfect tool. You don't need a protractor. This is like, I think it goes all the way up to about 12 inches, which honestly, like, I lost my center because I didn't really have a true center, but this is a 12 inch square piece of paper. So basically you can pretty much use this for the whole thing. That's on Amazon. I'll have to put it on like my favorites tonight, because I didn't. Anthony showed it to me. If you guys shoot me a message on Instagram after the live, I'll send you the link, because like Anthony sent it to me. But yeah, it was like $6 and like, you know, almost about $7 roughly on Amazon, and it's awesome. So definitely recommend. Super. I used it for this one to make the larger circles on the dolphin, because I think the original thing that I have only makes the circle to about this point. So I used it for all of these. So yeah, highly recommend. Anthony is great. He has some really freaking neat ideas. Sometimes they're a little wacky, but like he's helped me a lot with certain things. If I'm like ever kind of struggling with an idea or whatever it might be, like he's always like the first to jump on and like give me some, you know, thoughts or recommendations or anything like that. Like he's definitely sent some like really freaking cool ideas my way for sure. So yeah, that one was all Anthony. He sent it to me, and I kind of was thinking about it for a while, you know, because sometimes it sucks to have to buy new things, but ultimately I decided, you know, it was only about $7. So I, here, hold on. I will tell you, I can probably look it up in our chat. So give me a second. Give me a second. It's a helix tool. I know that for sure. Give me a sec. I can find it. How do I get to my messages on my iPad? As you can see, Anthony just sends me a bunch of random stuff. Was it this one? No. Hold on. I might have gotten too fast. Hold on. Nope. A little further. Hold on. Aha, here it is. And do a screenshot. Oh, $6.79, I was right. So here it is. Oh, I'm so glad you love it. Oh, do they? Good to know. So screenshot this, you guys, if you're interested in grabbing that tool. I'm telling you, it's awesome. Yeah, you didn't get to choose colors. I just kind of, you know, just sent me a blue one. I really don't care. It does the job, so. Well, good to know. They have other dolphin shapes. Yeah, I couldn't remember if I got it from them or not, because I know that last year there was like another place that I was getting a lot of my wood pieces from, and I still like them, but like the wood just isn't as nice of a quality as what you can get from like 24 Hour Crafts. I don't know, those of you guys who have purchased like wooden shapes, those of you guys who have purchased from 24 Hour Crafts and also from other places, can you confirm that their quality of wood is just like so much freaking nicer than any of the other places? I don't know, they just must sand their wood really well. Like, the cuts are always nice and smooth, too. Like, I don't know. I prefer 24-hour crafts above any other place that I will go to for my wooden shapes. But yeah, I know that they have a bunch of stuff. The only thing I wish they had a couple different frogs. Maybe I should reach out to them and ask if they can add a different frog, because the frogs that I've been painting, I don't get from 24-hour crafts. I have to get them elsewhere. And if I could, I would only get them from 24-hour crafts, but they just don't have the frog shape that I want. But yeah, definitely recommend. Oh, so it worked. Perfect. Yeah, it's linked in my bio. I am now an affiliate for 24-hour crafts, so I can get you guys some extra monies off of your wood pieces. It doesn't work on their Etsy. It only works on their website. But their website is cheaper than Etsy anyways. So, like, you know, who cares? How long have you... I've been on for... I got on around 6:30. Maybe it was a couple minutes after 6:30. So we're almost done for the night. We got about a couple minutes over 15 minutes left. So I'm getting off at 8. And it's like 7:44 right now. So got about 15 minutes left in tonight's live, which is fine. We'll be on again tomorrow. But yeah, I couldn't wait to get on live and tell you guys the news about my 24-hour crafts thing, since, you know, we've been kind of going back and forth, or I've been going back and forth about even asking them for a discount code, but I finally did. And now we have a little discount. It's not much. I mean, it's 10%, but, you know, coupled with the sale that they already have going on their website, that probably gets you about, you know, maybe 30-40% off, I think. I don't know. I know on Etsy they have a 30% off sale, and I think it's the same on their website. So, you know, add an extra 10% with their already sales, like, you know, you guys get some pretty nice discount. How's your Aussie? It's great. Let me show you. Because it is done. It's just I can touch it and everything. It's just, you know, resin needs technically a few days to fully cure, but it is good. Currently, I am waiting on a response from the place that, like, you know, you wanted stickers. So I had a couple questions for them, so I'm waiting for them to respond before I place an order for stickers. But at least this is done. Yeah, every little bit does help. But look how, like, I mean, the color shifts were already awesome, but, like, it just looks so much better under resin. So, here it is, all done.
I'm glad you love him.
I also finished the frog for Terry from the other night. So, this one is done. It's glittery. You can kind of see it sparkle a little bit. I can see it more in person, but... there's some sparkles, but yeah, here's her frog. I've been hard at work. Hard at work. All right. Time to, I want to use some bigger dots. I gotta count again. Well, sort of, I guess. I don't really know. Meh. What color do I want to use? Probably this, like, baby blue, maybe. Yeah, I know. I have to place an order for more mini frogs. I just haven't yet, because I just, you know, it's been a slow month. But I want to place an order for some more mini frogs, and some, like, mini frogs, and, like, different, like, one that isn't, like, their legs are just, like, in different positions, which I think would be pretty cool to have, like, you know, multiple different ones. So maybe sometime this week or next week, maybe. I'm gonna place another order. I think that's just kind of how it is in a February, honestly. Like, my February last year was terrible. It was, I think, my worst month, like, in sales out of the entire year. I think I struggled to even, like, break 1,000, and that's, like, not counting, like, 1,000 after me, like taking out whatever I spent on the month, like just 1,000, like period. So I think I like probably only made like a few $100 at the time, because my cost to like, profit is like kind of low. But I mean it's higher now, but still probably not where it should be. So yeah, February and March really sucked for me last year, and so far it's the same. But yeah, we'll see. It yeah, I think everything, like just I mean, money's tight everywhere. And I just kind of have to let it like not bother me, because I, automatically go to like that, well, no one wants your art because it's not good. It's not that. It's just people, money is tight and people can't, afford to spend money on, luxury items. I mean, this is kind of a luxury item. It's not a need, right? It's just a want. So I just kind of have to not, talk down on myself, and get myself down. But it's real hard sometimes. A few different dolphins on their site or frogs? Because I've seen their frogs, and I don't like. I don't like the position of them. I wish they had others, but oh well. Oh, thank you. I wish I could like make it cheap, but I cannot. Well, I mean, some of it's cheap, but in general, it's not. Got paint all over my hand. I might not use this circle as like a guide at all. I guess we'll see. Oops, I missed a comment. I'm sorry. I missed the pin comment. I guess I was looking down and it disappeared. That is true. But I do it kind of on purpose, because I mean, obviously, I want to profit, but I don't. I want to make sure anybody can pretty much use my art. Oh, my art is the best, thank you. Hello, what's going on? How's your night going? Ugh, I hate when that happens. I've been struggling to sleep the last few nights. Like, it's hard to fall asleep. And then, of course, once I do fall asleep, it's late as hell, and then I sleep in. Like, I woke up today at, like, 10:30, which, for me, is an hour and a half to about an hour and a half to 2 hours past, like, the time that I like to wake up, you know, because I have things to do. Especially if I, like, you know, I'm planning on going to the gym, I'd rather go earlier. And so when I woke up at 10:30 today, I'm like, well, I guess I'm not going to the gym today because I have a shit ton of things to do. And just, you know, taking an hour out of my morning just didn't seem doable today. Is it? I don't know. But yeah, I just, like, really have just struggled. Like, I haven't gone to bed until about 3 o'clock in the morning for the last few nights. It's been really weird. I'm sure if, like, Scott shut the TV off, like, I probably would go to sleep earlier. But usually I don't have that issue. I just fall asleep while the TV's on. But the last few nights, I just haven't been able to go to sleep. Don't blame the coffee, because I always have coffee. We actually had coffee earlier in the day, so it had definitely worn off by that point. Hey! Were you able to get those, were you able to order those pen holder things for the paint off of Dollar Tree's website? I wonder how much the shipping is, because I was trying to get more, but it wouldn't let me, like, set my store, because it says, like, what, free shipping to the store or whatever, but it wouldn't let me do it, so I didn't proceed with the transaction. So I don't know how, like, crazy shipping is when you order, like, off their website like that. What? Damn. That's ridiculous. I didn't even look to see if maybe they didn't ship to me. I'll have to look into it and see if, like, if you're willing to see if I can't, like, get it shipped to me and then ship it to you. Like, I don't know how much shipping's gonna be, but I'm always willing to do that. You can't sleep unless the TV's on? Oh, no. I need, like, pitch black and silence. Well, damn. I'm going to have to look it up and see if that's, like, the same for me or not. I don't think it's the same. I don't know. I've never ordered anything off Dollar Tree online, though. And I've seen them, like, elsewhere, but, like, you know, I don't know for sure, like, the sizing, you know, like, it could work. Like, if you go on, like, AliExpress, you can find some. But, like, I can't guarantee that the size is gonna be the same, so, like, it might work, it might not, you know, so. Like, the delivery was $41, or, like, all together, like, it was, you know, the price of the, you know, case plus delivery was $41. Yeah, I think that it's weird with Dollar Tree because, like, so I used to work at Dollar Tree when I was in college, and, like, they don't, like, order trucks. Dollar Tree just ships them, like, you know, based on what they sell, it just ships things. And some stuff is more, like, seasonal, so, like, if it's, like, a school supply, so, like, basically what that is, they, you know, once the store runs out, if it's not, like, school supply season, they don't typically get more until, you know, the next school season comes around. So, like, once they run out, sometimes they don't get any more. And, I asked, like, at my Dollar Tree, like, near my house, I asked if they would, if they could order some for me, and they said they literally can't, like, at all. They don't have any control over, like, what comes to the store. So, like, that's why, like, you know, I can't guarantee that things that I find at Dollar Tree, you're gonna find at Dollar Tree. Because, like, my store just might have extra because, you know, they just do. I don't know. But I know that you can get them online, but obviously the shipping was weird for some people. Yes, my link is in my bio, but it's jgrons, just like you see here, jgrons.art.com. So if you go to, like, my, like, main profile here on TikTok, there's a link tree link, and it's the first one. I think it says, like, shop my website or something like that. But it's a Shopify website, so it's not, like, Etsy or anything, but still, you know, still a trusted website. Don't worry. Yeah, but you can always look online. They might be able to ship to you, depending on where you are, but they might be able to ship to you. I'll have to look to see if I can get it shipped to me, because I've just been able to find, you know, a bunch of them at, like, you know, surrounding Dollar Trees in my area, but not everybody's so lucky. Yeah, you're welcome. Whoops, not enough. It's almost 8 o'clock. I'm keeping an eye on my time. Well, basically more so just seeing when Scott's done. But as always, you guys, I will be on again tomorrow, probably around the same time, 6:30 Eastern Standard Time till about 8 o'clock. And unless I get my shipment from 24 Hour Crafts in, because I do have a couple custom orders, but I don't have the pieces yet to paint. So unless they come tomorrow, we will be working on this tomorrow. But if they do come tomorrow, then we might be working on one of the custom orders. That's as long as I can, you know, confirm a color scheme with the person. But we might be finishing this or continue to work on this tomorrow. I just don't know for sure. Seriously? Yeah, mine, like, disappeared for a while, and then, like, I found more recently. So they just might have gotten lucky, you know, and I got more in. Yeah, these colors are fun. I'm having a good time with these colors. Like, I knew right away that I wanted to do some kind of, like, bluey, like, sea theme kind of color scheme with it. Use some pretty, like, color shifts and metallics on it as well. I'll bring more, like, color shift and metallics into the design as I bring it out more and get to do top dots. But I'm excited for this one because this one's going to be, like, pretty big. So, seriously, damn. We'll have to see what mine... I know mine had a handful left last time I was there. I didn't buy them because I didn't need any. I might be able to pick some up for you. I'll just have to see what they have. As long as you're not picky on the color, because there's 3 different colors, but, you know, they might only have green ones or pink ones or blue ones or whatever. The store near me has been the one that I can find the most at. The couple other stores, they either have 0 or they only have, like, 1 or 2. But mine always seem to have the most at any given time. Oh, your dog on my TikTok. So I have repurposed their, like, plastic square pen holders into paint holders. Here, I'll show you in a second. I just glue them together and I stack them up, and it fits, like, my acrylic paint bottles, like, literally freaking perfectly. You can put 4 bottles in each. So I just grabbed a bunch. This has been since like fall of last year that I've been collecting these square pen holders, and I just glue them together, and they basically they're just stacked kind of against my wall. Like, it's not glued to my wall or anything. They're just kind of glued together. But yeah, like, it literally just like holds all this paint. And like, some stores have them, some don't. I know you can find them online at Dollar Tree, but I guess Dollar Tree doesn't ship everywhere, only ships to certain places. So I grab a few pretty much every time I go, just so that, you know, if I need to add more, I do. But as you can see, I have quite a bit of space now at this point, because I've organized my paint a little better. All of this is full. I just have the colors down with me right now. But yeah, so a lot of people kind of liked this setup, and they were asking where I got them, and yeah. Oh yeah. I'm sad though, 'cause like TikTok has been like messing with my views. And so it doesn't really have many views. I wanted to show it off, but you know, I never know. Never know what's gonna take off and what's not on TikTok, you know? It really is, and I just don't know what the heck is going on. I'm losing followers faster than I can gain them, which, I mean, I don't know if it's a me thing or if it's just like TikTok clearing things out. Like, I don't know. And I just, like, my views, I just can't seem to really get my views up. And it's not like my stuff is really much different. I mean, the only thing I can think of is that I'm not showing my face as much as I used to, but I just like, I don't know, I haven't like had to make a video like with my face as much as I used to. I don't know. So. I also like heard somewhere that if you don't usually post multiple times a day and then you start posting multiple times a day, it's like throwing the algorithm off. And like, so far, like in 2023, I've been trying to post more often, just because that was something that I struggled with a lot last year, was like regularly posting, you know, even a video a day, I really struggled with last year. And so this year, I've been trying really hard to post like, you know, a couple videos every day. And so I heard somewhere that that kind of, you know, might be one of the reasons why my account is struggling right now. So I'm kind of just hoping like eventually it just realizes that like, hey, I'm gonna be, you know, posting videos more often now. But I don't know. There's just like weird stuff going on, and it's just making me sad. What's 629? Oh, views. Yeah, well, that's better than it was, 'cause like earlier it was at like 13 views, and I had posted it like, you know, at least a couple hours before, and I'm like, what the hell? I know it's past 8 o'clock, by the way. I'm just, you know, Scott's not done with work yet, so I'm gonna give it a couple more minutes, and then I'm gonna hop off because my Starbucks closes at 8:30. So if he's not done with work, I'm gonna have to go get our Starbucks. So, you know, because we need our Starbucks fix. Well, 600 views is better than what I've been getting. Some stuff I can't like break out over like 200, and I'm just like, what the frick? The frick? So we'll get these like couple swooshes in, and then I'm gonna hop off for the night. I don't know if that's actually like a true real thing or if it's something that people make up, you know, because like I've definitely like gotten shadow banned or what I think might be a shadow ban for, you know, a little bit of time, but then it like, you know, just, you know, changes. I think it's just something with the algorithm, you know, and just weird things. And like, I'm not following these stupid trends right now because like that none of it fits with my art, and I'm not just gonna randomly like, you know, use one of those videos or those trends right now to make my videos any better, because it just doesn't make sense. I got a couple bubbles. All right, so we're gonna stop here for tonight, you guys. And I will see you guys tomorrow. We may or may not pick up on this one. Or we might work on a custom order. I'm not sure. But thank you guys for hanging out with me. And I will see you guys tomorrow for like an hour and a half or so, around like 6:30-ish till about 8. So, yeah. Have a wonderful night. I'll see you guys later. Bye.